Hey everyone, Grant here for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous video, we looked at the marker functionality in the Flame 2018.1 update. We covered marker and segment marker basics, as well as the new markers view that gives a holistic perspective of all your markers in the current sequence. You could also filter your markers for focused work, and finally, the markers view can also double up as a fast navigational tool, so you can keep well informed as you work within the Flame products. However, there is always the scenario when your producer or client is not around and you need to send them a draft version of the sequence. Now you can already burn information into the image using the burnin metadata tool, and this can provide details such as tape name, timecodes, segment information, etc. In the Flame 2018.1 update, you can now burn marker information into the image as part of the burnin metadata layers. If you would like to follow along, just use a sequence with multiple markers and segment markers. Now, the quickest way to apply burnin metadata to the sequence is to create a video track above the edit and select the empty gap segment. Call up the effects ribbon by pressing Ctrl Tab and choose the burnin metadata timeline effects. Double-click on the burnin metadata button to enter the timeline effects editor. Now, the burnin metadata tool works using a series of layers. For example, you could click the Add button and add record timecode. This particular layer will read the sequence record timecode and burn it into the image. So there is a variety of metadata you can choose from, and if you want to know more about burnin metadata in general, please watch the detailed video on burnin metadata via the Flame Learning channel. Now you can delete the current layer and create a new one, or you can just select it and change what metadata is displayed in this layer. Click the pull-down menu and choose Marker. As with all burnin metadata layers, you can customize everything about the displayed information. For this video, I'd like you to focus on the layer specifics. By default, the marker label is displayed, and you can change this text if you want to call the marker by a different name. Now you can choose to show the name of the marker, the comment associated with the marker, or a combination of both. So you can decide how much or how little to inform your producer with regards to the marker. Finally, you can choose a color for this text via the regular menus, or just click this button to assign the marker color to the text. So that's how you set up a burnin marker and choose what you want to see. However, there are a few extra pointers you need to know. Firstly, the marker information you see on screen is the standard marker for the sequence. Exiting the editor, you will see that I'm referring to the markers along the timecode bar at the bottom of the sequence. But it is also possible to display the information of the segment markers. Now I have a segment marker at the same time as the marker in my sequence. We'll come back to that point in a minute. But if you go back into the Timeline Effects editor and you want to display the segment marker info instead of the marker information, just toggle which marker you'd like to see in the layer specifics. So you can choose between displaying a marker or a segment marker in this layer. If you want to display both the marker and the segment marker at the same time, all you need to do is add another layer and choose the marker option again. You can then customize this information to match the marker or segment marker you'd like to display. The other important point that I'd like to point out with this method is if you exit the Timeline Effects editor, you will see that we're using a gap clip on the top video track to apply the burnin metadata timeline effects. By its design, the gap timeline effects will read the metadata of the marker on the timecode bar. However, when it comes to the segment marker, the gap timeline effects will only read the first video segment beneath it. so all segment markers should be on the topmost video track to be displayed with the gap timeline effects. You could opt to apply the burn-in metadata timeline effects directly to each segment, but then the burn-in metadata becomes part of the composite, which may not be what you want. Finally, it may not be obvious to some, but I just want to mention that for the marker or segment marker to be displayed in the burn-in metadata timeline effects, you need to be on the same frame as the marker or segment marker in the sequence. Currently, the marker information will only be displayed for the frame it is on within the sequence. Just bear that in mind when you play back the clip with burn-in metadata applied. Be sure to check out the other updates to the Flame 2018.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.